Got one more thing to mention.
Do it.
If a new arcade opened up in the area, so if you're from the San Francisco Bay Area, listen up. This weekend I went to Game Center Arcade. It's right in the middle of downtown San Mateo, just to check it out. And I think anyone who checks it out will be pleasantly surprised. They've got their full lineup of fighting games. And when I went to Southtown Arcade a couple of weeks ago in San Francisco, I was mentioning how it was very fighting game heavy. But at Game Center, the owner, Myung Kim, said he's trying to be a little more conscientious and stock a wider variety of arcade games for people to check out.
Cool.
So if you're not a hardcore fighting game aficionado, there's other stuff there for you. So, for instance, they've got some shooters like Ikaruga and Escaluda 2, I believe. Got Virtua Cop 3, which is fantastic. And then some super old school stuff like the Capcom's Dungeons & Dragons game. And
oh, I love
even,
that game.
Wait, Magical is that, Drop 3, I know.
Shadow of Mistar or whatever?
It's the first one, I think. Tower of Doom.
Okay, yeah, that's pretty good too.
Yeah. But yeah, and you know, like I said, they've got plenty of fighting games, so you're in good company there. Street Fighter, Marvel vs. Capcom, all the regulars. And what really caught me by surprise, they have this whole side area where they have just a bunch of open TVs. You can, I guess, bring in your consoles if you want and hook them up and just play games with your friends there if you shell out a few bucks to use that area.
Oh, cool.
So yeah, when I was there, they were having like a huge Smash Brothers tournament, had it running on 3 or 4 TVs. One was very much like the tiny 20-inch CRT that I was playing Smash Brothers on in college, so that was that was fantastic. I was like, oh, I know that TV.
There's a bit of a sort of arcade renaissance in the San Francisco area, huh?
It seems like it's trying real hard to come back. I asked them how long they had been in business, and it turns out they've been open for just about a month.
Oh, cool. Wow, so, that is really
so
new.
So absolutely brand new. So go there and show them your support.
Yeah, guys, go there. I'm going to drive there right now.
They're on 47 South B Street in the middle of San Mateo, right down the street from the movie theater. And they're open Wednesday through Sunday, 3 p.m. to midnight. And, in fact, I think you can go and pay, like, I think it's $7, and they give you a wristband. You can play a selection of their fighting games for free all day. That's like your all-day pass.
Oh, man, cool. That is awesome.
So if that sounds like a good thing to you, check them out. And we'll have some links up on the website where you can go get more information.
Oh, sweet, man.
Game Center Arcade. Absolutely worth taking a look if you're in the Bay Area.
I want to go to the Bay Area.
That does sound pretty awesome. I mean, so you just spent like the entire day there or what?
I didn't opt for the all-day pass because the people on the fighting game machines at that point were looking kind of crazy.
Oh, no, yeah.
So I ended up spending an enormous amount of money playing Ikaruga, which is one of my all-time favorites. I never played it in an arcade setting before, always on a console, so that was definitely a cool experience.
Cool. So are they sort of like the big, crazy arcade cabinets, or are these sort of custom things that have...
It was kind of a mix. Like, a few of them were the Japanese sit-down cabinets. They had a bunch of, like, all the all-day pass fighting game cabinets are actually, I think they were custom PS3 arcade cabinets. Yeah. So you even had some interesting home games on there, like, I think it was Arcana Heart 3, everybody's favorite underage schoolgirl fighting game. but yeah, there's
I know it's
definitely
mine.
Plenty of stuff. Oh, yeah.
Cool. That's awesome. No, that's one of the things I sort of remembered loving about arcades sort of back in the day was the, you know, the giant cabinets that had the sniper rifles mounted to them and just, you know, the crazy.
Oh, you know, they don't have a lot of those. I guess it's because the space is sort of a premium and he's got kind of like the perfect amount of consoles in there right now.
Yeah.
And when he brings in one of those huge machines, he has to take a bunch out.
Right.
Yeah, so that Star
but
Wars
definitely
arcade
a nice
game,
mix.
Not there.
I saw a virtual on machine hiding in the back. I was like, oh, when are they going to hook that up?
Awesome.
So, worth a look. Check it out. They've got rotating events. Like, I think it was a few weeks ago, they had somebody come in, bring in a bunch of just shooting games, which I'm really sore that I missed out on. I wish I had known that was going on, because I would have loved to see that.